It's not just a schedule for one ball with 8:30 minutes time limit. Your referee, Bryce Remsberg. West Lawn, Pennsylvania. He is the master of a thousand holds, Mike Quackenbush.
Quack looking focused here.
And his opponent from the United Banks of Switzerland, Double C, Claudio Castagnoli.
Double C apparently coming from his job as a nurse. Ah, there we go.
Stripper Ben. One of his outfits that he wears to the parties. He does bachelor parties all the time for
bachelor parties.
Same-sex couples, yes.
It's not true.
Yes, it is. I read it on the internet.
Here we go. Double C and Quackenbush. Round two, 2006 Ted Petty Invitational. And Double C goes right after the back of Mike Quackenbush's, which, as we all know, is a weakness.
Like a baby seal.
Knuckle lock now. I don't know, look at this. Oh, wow. And Double C not taking kindly to being shown up there at all. You could see that look on his face. He looked embarrassed and angry.
This is my house, bitch.
Double C usually beloved here in Midlothian, but tonight this crowd firmly behind Mike Quackenbush.
It's kind of hard to be loved. Personally, I don't like Quack, but.
Quackenbush now,
like anyone,
works his way to reverse the hold. Nicely done. But Claudio just so strong, able to carry the weight.
Strong and he's tall, so get that leverage right away.
Oh, wait a minute. All the way around, head scissors takedown. Forearm again. You see Claudio, when he gets embarrassed, when Quackenbush kind of runs circles around him, the first thing he does is just blast him.
I'd say keep running, Quack. You're going to get tired eventually. Run circles with me all day.
Oh, there's
that you're getting a European uppercut.
European uppercut sends Quack all the way into the corner.
I'm going to make a new rule. You can only throw European uppercuts if you're of a European descent.
Okay.
So, like, Trick Davis couldn't throw a European uppercut.
Okay.
He's just a white kid from Chicago. Now, me, I'm Italian. So, did I mention that before that I'm Italian?
Yeah,
ben?
Yeah, you did. A nice arm drag. Again, you see Quackenbush one step ahead of Claudio. Oh, wow. Are you
Claudio
kidding
has
me?
No idea what's going on right now.
Quackenbush is all over Claudio. And now here he goes. Up and over, takes him out. Beautifully done.
Quack is riding Claudio like a cheap suit.
Yeah, he is. He is all over Claudio. I think Claudio came in a little overconfident. And Quackenbush, using every trick in his book, all 1,000 holds, I think, have been used already in this match.
I don't know about that.
Bodies.
That's a big number,
stuff
man.
I've never even seen.
Well, you're not as well versed in the wrestling world as I am. I've seen a lot of them.
Oh, catches him, and there's the power of Claudio Castagnoli.
You know, you can run all you want, but once again, like M-Dog, they call it a high-risk move because there's
high risk,
taking a chance.
Claudio, so powerful, caught Mike Quackenbush right there out of midair, spun him all the way around for a backbreaker, and you can see Claudio knows very well the back hit, the injury history of the back on Mike Quackenbush. It cost him last year in the Ted Petty Invitational when he had an injured back going into his match with Kevin Steen, and Steen attacked him before the bell, and then just an onslaught on the lower back of Mike Quackenbush ended up costing him the match. That one mistake is all Claudio needed, and now the door is, and the momentum has started to swing. Oh, vicious kick just sends Quackenbush to the mat. All the way around. Oh, wow! Look at that! Penny combination! Wow! And again, we've seen it now. This is the third time that Claudio has been able to stop the momentum. Very, very cocky cover there. Slams him down. Now what does Claudio have in mind? Oh, come on!
You know, in a tournament like this, being the second round, I understand he wants to show him up. You know, Claudio's probably a little upset at what happened earlier with Quack running around him, but you can't be cocky and covering with one boot and flexing. Forget these fans, forget everything else. Keep your eye on the prize and go for the finals of this tournament.
Very true, and something that's going to be a theme in all these second round matches is the fact that if you plan on winning this tournament, you're going to have to win three matches here tonight, including a three-way at the end of the night.
Yeah.
So you want to conserve as much energy in this first match as possible. But on the same hand, the card's stacked. I mean, you can't take a round off. You can't take a round lightly.
But you also don't want to put all of your eggs in one basket in one match. I mean, you don't want to put all of your moves into one thing, because every guy is scouting every match, especially the winners. Like Generico, for instance, he's going to be able to watch every winner tonight and know what they're going to hit, what their weaknesses are, what's hurting on them, and what's not.
Sure, and we saw M-Dog 20 miscalculate. If you notice that someone miscalculates something or they slipped on the ropes trying to move, you can probably tell yourself, if I have to face that guy down the line, he's probably not going to try that again.
Oh, yeah. And if you think about it, technically, Generico is in the best position right now for this tournament due to the fact that he was the first match tonight. He has the most reaction or recovery time to come back.
No, absolutely, I agree 100%. Look at that! Monkey flip all the way to the outside, and Quackenbush is going to launch himself again here, I think. Last time worked out very well for Mike Quackenbush. This time, slides through, I think. Yes, Claudio moved out of the way. Whoa, onto the second rope! Drag, are you kidding me? Wow, catches him with an arm drag. Mike Quackenbush is absolutely amazing. We talked about body control with M-Dog 20. There is body control for you. He had control over everything he was doing, and he ended up on top there. And now Quackenbush throws Claudio back into the ring. Now gonna go up to the top rope. What's he got in mind? Claudio to his feet though. European uppercut stops Quackenbush in his tracks. Now throws him off, but rolls through on the slam. Very impressive. Now all the way up. Penny combination! Oh! You could see the shock on the face of Mike Quackenbush. He thought for sure he had that cinched in. But Claudio just so powerful. Mike Quackenbush sat in that chair just last night and talked about the conditioning of Claudio Castagnoli. And now, there he goes, he hits him. Two. Claudio cannot believe he did not get the pin there.
Okay.
Yeah, that's the I knew I had it. The water slide is that angle slam variation. Are you kidding?
Yes!
Hook some up! Come on! One, two! No! Claudio! Find a way again! And this crowd is on their feet as they should be! Head of steam now. All the way through, pinning. Three, and Claudio Castagnoli reverses Quackenbush. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. Double C out of nowhere. Shocks Mike Quackenbush. Quackenbush looked like he had this match won.
Well, Ben, I'm going to get in the back because hanging out with you is about as exciting as finding out you got herpes, so I got to go.